When I was in Scotland, I've actually been to Scotland twice. I went in 1997 and I was there for 12 weeks. And then I had a very short opportunity to go in May 2 years ago. And I was really just there for 2 weeks. But what I went to do my research, but really what I ended up doing is talking to them about education and environmental accounting education. And we talked about a variety of ideas for my course because I'm never satisfied with this course. And it's a ton of work, and I always am looking for new ideas. And one of the things I talked about with my colleagues is bringing an environmental disaster into the classroom and then having students take stakeholder roles. Now, a stakeholder is someone who has a stake in what that organization does. I think it's easier for students to get something when they can relate to it, okay? And I had done some research on the Olympic pipeline explosion. My research question was, there's four corporate owners, how are they going to report this at the end of 1999 in their annual reports? And what I saw was fascinating from my perspective and from the perspective as an educator of accounting, is that we have kind of standards on how things are supposed to happen in the reporting world. We have a conceptual framework of accounting that guides us, and yet each of those four organizations reported the disaster in very different ways. And so one way that I've dealt with that is I've just brought the example to class and I've, you know, put it up on the overhead, and so they get to see without really thinking about it ahead of time. But I think it's better if you have them grapple with the issue and think about, well, how should this be reported? And then you show them what happened. To me, that's a better way of learning and stimulating lifelong learning skills and stimulating their interest. But the other thing that I realized is that when I looked at, for example, Texaco's annual report for 1999, they didn't disclose very much, mind you. But they talked about two things. They talked about the explosion that killed somebody in Anacortes in their footnotes. And they talked about the Olympic pipeline explosion in their footnotes, very briefly. And when I read the thing in Anacortes, it was far enough removed that I didn't have an emotional response. But when I read about the pipeline explosion, I got chills. And I thought, okay, if I can give the students something that gives them chills because it happens so close to home, then that's important. Now, this particular assignment, I think, I'm really excited about because we can pick apart the conceptual framework of accounting. And the first way we can think about it is the concept of materiality. Now, typically, what materiality means is relative size. And so if an organization, you know, in the books, if there's been a mistake in the calculation of purchases, if it's relatively small compared to the whole organization, we don't worry about that, okay? So that's what I mean by relative size. And what's important to me about this particular assignment is that the Olympic pipeline explosion was pretty immaterial to at least three of the four corporate owners. And I think that guided how they reported. In terms of size, I think it's really hard to grasp how huge Texaco is. And when I looked at the 10K, which is the report they file with the SEC, it's that thick. I mean, it's absolutely huge. What happened in Bellingham is a blip. It's like a fly on the wall for a corporation that size. And what I think is really interesting about the Olympic pipeline explosion and why I use it in my class is because it's clearly material to everyone in this community at some level, especially if we were here. And when I pass out the assignment, even 8 years later, there's chatter about where people were when it happened. Even though a lot of the students were in Seattle or across the mountains or wherever they were, there's still chatter this many years later about where they were and what they remember. And so I think it helps them to understand materiality a little bit better, that it's not just size. And that as professional accountants, we want to think about not just size, but we want to think about the quality of the event in the decision to report to the public.